It is Tuesday, September 22nd, 2020, and this is an update on the Three Gorges Dam and current events in China. First, we're going to have a look at the water level at the Three Gorges Dam, followed by China's pork reserves running out as prices soar, analysts say. Next, courtesy of strangesounds.org, is another famine looming in China. We also have some new tweets. Let's hop into it. And a brief caveat before today's video. While researching for these reports, I come across information from various sources. Just because I decide to include a piece of information doesn't necessarily mean that I agree with it. I like to let you decide for yourself. Moving on. For those of you that don't regularly follow the live stream at the Three Gorges Dam, there's usually two cameras live streaming, well, most of the time at least, from the dam, a spillway angle camera and a side angle camera. In the last 48 hours, the side angle camera has been disabled, and the spillway angle camera has been repositioned to point downstream where you can't actually see the dam, and that camera has actually been disabled in the last few hours as well. I just thought that was worth passing along. And let's have a quick look at the status of the water level at the Three Gorges Dam before we start on today's articles. The current water level at the Three Gorges Dam is 160.69 meters. The current inflow is not listed, and the current outflow sits at 26,300 cubic meters per second. It is worth noting that these numbers are released by the CCP. And as we can see from the chart currently pictured, in the past 24 hours, the water level at the Three Gorges Reservoir has risen from 160.57 meters to 160.69 meters. Upstream, at Kuntan, the situation continues to be the exact opposite, where just 24 hours ago the water level was 171.8 meters. It currently sits at 170.6 meters. And this comes courtesy of financialtimes.com. China's pork reserves running out as prices soar, analysts say. China has nearly exhausted its reserves of frozen pork. According to new estimates that underscore the supply shortfall in the world's top protein market, the level of reserves is a state secret in China, the world's number one producer, consumer, and importer of pork. But Indo-Economics, a London-based consultancy focused on China, estimates that reserves fell by about 452,000 tons between September 2019 and August of this year. China has less than 100,000 tons of pork reserves remaining, says Diana Choileva, Indo's chief economist. At this rate, within 2 or 3 months, they'll be out, she added. The numbers back up comments from the U.S. agriculture attaché in Beijing in a recent livestock report on China, which noted that pork reserves appear to have been mostly depleted by the third quarter of 2020. The country reported its first case of ASF in 2018. Since then, more than 100 million pigs have been affected, pushing pork prices up to record highs. In response, China has sold frozen meat from its reserves into the domestic market to try and restrain prices. Despite inching down from their highs, spot wholesale prices are still more than double their pre-ASF levels. The cost of pork to consumers rose more than 50% in August from a year earlier, according to official data. The pork reserves act to stabilize high prices, rather than to provide a replacement for tight supplies. The decline in reserves means that Beijing's ability to directly intervene in the pork market will be more limited in the second half of 2020 and into 2021, warned the USDA report. The shortage has forced China to import record amounts of the meat this year from top producers including the U.S., despite President Xi Jinping's push for greater agricultural self-sufficiency. Pork imports hit 430,000 tons in July, more than doubling from a year before. China's demand is at record levels this year. It is the kingmaker in the global meat trade, said Justin Sherrard, global strategist for animal protein at Rabobank. The country is the world's largest meat consumer. Over the past 5 years, China's average annual demand for pork has been about 50 million tons, according to USDA data. Darren Friedrichs, an analyst at commodities broker StoneX in Shanghai, said it was likely that the surge in imports, rather than the depletion of China's reserves, was going to have a much bigger impact on pork prices. Sales from Beijing's reserves were more about showing they are doing something, he added. Chinese farmers, enticed by high pork prices, have returned in droves to raising hogs. Piglet prices have also surged, pushing up imports of feed grains as farmers expand their herds. That has driven a rally in global feed markets, with soybean futures in Chicago rising above $10 a bushel in September to the highest level in more than 2 years. A greater reliance on imports is politically tricky for Beijing. When China resumed imports of Canadian meat late last year after a four-month hiatus, a foreign ministry official warned it was not a sign of thawing relations. Last week, China banned pork imports from Germany. Thank you for watching this video. If you're finding it informative, please consider giving the channel a subscribe. And this is courtesy of strangesounds.org. Is another famine looming in China? China, which embarked on the mission of becoming a superpower by showing its economic and military might to the world, now may be brought to its knees over a shortage of food. Reduction in overall domestic food production, a recent deluge in the Yangtze River Basin, the Rice Bowl of China, and a slash in imports, mostly aggravated by deteriorating diplomatic relations, has caused Beijing to hit the panic button. Chinese leader Xi Jinping's strategy may be to divert attention from China's pending food crisis, just as Mao Zedong did in 1962 to mask the failed Great Leap Forward movement. The Yangtze River Basin, which accounts for 70% of China's rice production, has seen the worst flood since 1939, damaging millions of acres of cropland. According to the China Meteorological Administration, the country has experienced a 20% increase in heavy rainfall since 1961, taking the water level of more than 400 rivers above the flood control line, with 33 of them reaching record highs. Soaring prices of agricultural products are stoking food security jitters in China. According to the China National Bureau of Statistics, food prices went up by 13% in July compared to the previous July. The price of pork rose about 85%. On a year-on-year basis, food prices have increased by 10% in 2020. The price of corn is 20% higher, and the price of soybeans is up 30%. According to global financial group Nomura, China's agricultural GDP could fall by nearly a percentage point in the July-September quarter, rendering losses of $1.7 billion in agriculture output. Chinese brokerage firm Shenwan Hongyuan has anticipated that China could lose 11.2 million tons of grain this year compared to last year. Although she claimed that the country's grain output increased this year, imports of grains have gone up almost 22% to 74 million tons in the first half of this year. Imports of wheat went up a whopping 197% during the same period. This has forced Beijing to release 62.5 tons of rice, 50 tons of corn, and 760,000 tons of soybeans from its strategic reserve. The amount is significantly higher than last year. The United States, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, and Indonesia are among the top exporters of agriculture commodities to China. Despite its dispute over tariffs with the U.S., China still remains heavily dependent on the United States to meet its food demand. China's agricultural imports in 2019 were pegged at $13.8 billion U.S. dollars, up from $9.1 billion in 2018, according to the U.S. Department of Agriculture. China's food shortfall will only get worse in the coming years. unless it undertakes major agricultural reforms, warns the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences. It is difficult to ascertain the real situation, since information coming out of China may not reflect the true severity of the shortage. And our last piece of information is a series of interesting tweets. And I think that's a good place to wrap up today's video. I hope that you found it informative, and check back soon for more content.